Hello. In this video, I will show you how to edit a software simulation in ActivePresenter 8. After you complete the recording, ActivePresenter will give you a series of slides. It can be a normal slide or a video slide. For video slides, you can edit them in the same way you edit a recorded video. This will be discussed in a different video. From now on, I will only talk about editing the normal slides. As you can see, all the slide names, smart annotations, cursor paths, mouse clicks, keystrokes, text boxes, and feedback messages are automatically generated. However, you can still change them to fit your preference. Let's start with the slides. You can delete those with unwanted content by clicking on them and pressing delete. You can also change the slide names by navigating to the properties pane. In the slide properties tab, extending the general section and changing the name in this box. The description box below lets you put on more details for the slide. You can add slide transition effects from this tab. Refer to this video for more details. Cursor paths are created based on the realistic mouse movement on screen in the capturing phase. However, it can still be changed in order to be clearer to users. To change the cursor path, click on the start point to select. Then drag the start point or end point to the designated position. Additionally, you can move the control point here to adjust the shape of the path. To change the cursor style, navigate to the properties pane, cursor section. Click this button and select the cursor image you prefer from the drop-down list. The timing and speed of the cursor can be adjusted in the timing section or in the timeline pane below. You can add a click point by selecting from the drop-down list here and adjusting its timing in this click time spin box. Change the cursor highlight and click effects in the cursor path section here. There's a tool that helps keep the continuity of the cursor path between slides called cursor snapping. It makes sure that whenever you move the end point in the current slide, the start point in the next slide will move correspondingly, and vice versa. You can turn off this function by opening the View tab and toggling this button off. Now when you move the end point of this slide, the start point of the next slide won't move anymore. On the other hand, if it's out of sync and you want the cursor path to be smooth between two slides, right-click the start point and select Snap to Previous. Or right-click the end point and select Snap to Next. Check out this video for more details. As for mouse clicks, you can select them and drag the handles to resize and reposition. You can also style them as normal objects by using the Commands in Format tab, or further customize them through the Properties pane. Refer to this video for more instruction. Smart annotations are shapes with added text, which are automatically generated to show users how to perform a particular step. You can change the text to further explain the step, or customize the shape for better visuals. Refer to this video for more detailed instructions. Feedback messages are also created automatically for simulation intent. They are initially hidden and only appear after a particular action. They show how well users do a specific task and help them get better at it. By default, only incorrect feedback messages are generated after recording. You can enable the correct and hover feedback messages before the capturing phase in the recording settings for software simulation dialog annotation tab. Tick the correct and hover checkboxes. The upper ones are for mouse click feedback messages, and the lower ones are for keystrokes, text entries. Back to editing, you can easily change the messages content and customize them to make the simulation more engaging. You can also add more feedback messages to your step by right-clicking on the object, click Insert, and select the type of message you want. Further instructions can be found in this video. It's always better to add narration in the editing phase instead of the capturing phase, because when you record your voice at the same time with the simulation, the audio might end up in different slides, and it costs you lots of time to synchronize them. To add narration to the slide, use this record narration function. Check the recording options before you start. Here you can choose the input device, adjust input volume, or calibrate the audio input. When everything is ready, click this record narration button and start speaking. When you finish, click the stop button. As your narration is added to the slide, freely edit it as a normal audio object. These are all the techniques you need to know to edit a software simulation. Give them a try and have fun with it. Thank you for watching.